Today's session, we learn about construction and working of cupola furnace. So it is a melting device used to melt cast iron. The outermost part of cupola furnace is a cylindrical steel shell, and equipments are fitted vertically inside this cylindrical shell with doors. The top side of cupola furnace is fitted with cap to prevent escape of harmful gases to environment. The cupola shell is made up of steel and has lining of refractory bricks. This furnace is supported on cast iron legs mounted on concrete base. Near bottom part, it has sand bed above which melted iron flow. This sand bed is tapered. Near elevated side of tapered sand bed, slag hole is present through which slag form from impurities. Near downside of down bed, tap hole is present through which molten iron comes out. Above the sand bed, air reaches the furnace and helps in combustion. Near the top of furnace, metal, coke and limestone are fed into furnace through charging door. During working of cupola furnace, wood is ignited above the sand bed. When the wood start burning properly, coke is dumped on the well from top. The combustion start in coke bed using fire from burning wood and using air from tires. At this time, the air blast is turned out at lower blowing rate than normal. After nearly 3 hours of burning, alternate layers of limestone, pig iron and coke is charged until it reaches the level of charging door. At this time, the air blast is turned on to normal blowing rate and combustion occurs more rapidly in coke bed. All oxygen from air blast is consumed by combustion, and in combustion zone, the temperature varies from 1150 to 1850 degrees Celsius. The portion of coke bed above the combustion zone is reducing zone. This zone prevents oxidation of metal charge. As the carbon dioxide moves through this zone, some of it reduced by following reaction. The layer of iron above reducing zone is melting zone, where solid iron is converted into molten iron. Above the melting zone, there is preheating zone, where charge is preheated by outgoing gases. Within 5 to 10 minutes of starting air blast to normal blowing rate, the first molten iron appears at the tap hole. The charging door is closed till the metal melts. The content of charge moves down as melting proceeds. When the melting process is finished and no more molten iron is required, the feed of charge is stopped and air blast is also stopped. The bottom plate is swung to open when probe is removed and slag is removed. Normally, cupola furnace is not used more than 4 hours, but can be used for 10 hours of continuous operation.